What is up, guys? Awesome Nerd Show here, and today we're doing this little mini opening and review of these figures. So these are the new DC Multiverse figures, and this is just a small set that comes with Wonder Woman and Wonder Girl, and they build Dr. Psycho. So it's just a small little tiny mini figure, build-a-figure guy, and so of course we'll look at it better. So we have Wonder Woman here, and so this is the Wonder Woman from the Batman Dark Knight Returns storyline. So if you've read that comic or seen it, this is what the Wonder Woman looks like from it. And then, of course, as I said, it builds Dr. Psycho there, which we'll look at in a second. And then we've got Wonder Girl as well to go along with it. So it's kind of like a Wonder Woman set to go along here is what this all is. So let's look at the back here. So there, of course, we have the Wonder Woman and the Wonder Girl. And then there's Dr. Psycho right there. So we'll go ahead and just open each one of these and look at them individually. Then, of course, we'll build Dr. Psycho at the end. So let's go ahead and open it. Okay, so here's the Wonder Woman. So this Wonder Woman looks really weird. So if you've seen Wonder Woman, she doesn't really look anything like this normally. But as I said, this is from the Dark Knight Returns storyline of Batman and stuff. So we get a weird looking version of Superman and Wonder Woman from that story. And so here's the Wonder Woman. So she does have her classic long black hair. So she still has that. But then her tiara has this like nose guard that comes down off the front of it. And so it makes her face look really weird. It looks like she's got like a flat face or a flat nose and stuff. And it just doesn't look that flattering. But it's just kind of weird. Like, I don't know why they... Obviously, that was from the story. Yeah, her nose even looks really flat on her face. But it just looks really weird in a figure form. Then she has her upper chest cover, I guess, here. It looks like barely anything. But it's in the shape of an eagle, as you can see. So you got the eagle head and then, of course, the wings coming out, covering her chest. And then it goes around to the back to just some strings tying it all together there. Then we got a belt with kind of like, I guess, some, it's not really her logo. I don't know what that logo is, unless it's just an Amazonian logo. She's got her gauntlets here, but again, they're a different design and look. It does have some of the point, kind of like her tiara does. And then again, some more of the strings holding them on. She's got like black gloves. Then she has some star-spangled pants here. And so it looks like, you know, just a part of the American flag here, but with the blue and all the stars and stuff. There's her lasso of truth, so she still has that. And then she's got these small, tiny shoes on, again, with the strings that look very something like you'd see out of ancient Greece, which, of course, fits along with her. But she doesn't normally wear this, these, like, kind of shoes in stories or, like, you know, in comics and especially the movies and stuff now. But that's really all that's to her, so let's look at her joints. So she has some weird joints. So there's her knee. I don't remember much about the DC figures. I don't believe their knees are like that, though. But she's got a different looking one, of course, probably since she doesn't have much covering on it. Then we do have a foot joint that looks just like a giant ball type socket, or like a ball thing here at the bottom, which looks kind of weird on her. Her legs do move right at the end of the pants, and then, of course, she has the normal movement back and forth of the legs. She does rotate, so she can rotate there. Of course, her arms, which have this weird looking joint, so obviously you can't bend the arm in certain directions, but you can if you her wrist twist. Then she's got a ball joint in the arm, so she can move in all different directions. Then, of course, the head. And so she doesn't have a whole lot of movement that she can do, and this figure does have some issues standing a little. But for weapons, she obviously has her lasso of truth, as I mentioned, and then she does come with like a little dagger, so you can stick this in her hand if you wanted. But normally she comes with the sword, but she doesn't this time. It's just a small dagger, and it does have like a red dot there, so it's supposed to be, oh look, China. So it has a red dot, so it's supposed to be designed of something or whatever. But that's it for Wonder Woman. And then for Dr. Psycho, she does come with the torso part here. And so obviously you can see he's in like a tuxedo or something. And then she comes with the arms. Let's see if I can get these in. Usually I don't build figures on camera because they're so hard to put together. But let's see if I can... Yeah, the arm's not going in there, so I'll have to do that off camera. But she comes with both arms and the upper torso. So that's it for her. So that's it for the Wonder Woman. Then next up here we have Wonder Girl. And so her real name, I believe, is like Cassie Sandmark or Sandmark, something like that. But she's a member of the Teen Titans currently. And she's a relative of Wonder Woman. Her storyline has changed that she's been like the daughter of Zeus. Or she's like niece of Wonder Woman, so her story just kind of changes and stuff over time, but she's currently Wonder Girl in the Teen Titans, so this is her form here. And so you can see there's her face. Obviously, she's a comic. She's not been in movies or anything, so she can't really look like anybody. But she's got the long blonde hair and like a headband going on there, holding her hair back. Then she's got the Wonder Woman logo there on her upper shirt. I don't know what you call clothing and stuff, but like this, her tank top type thing. Then she does have gauntlets, so she's pretty much just like Wonder Woman, all sorts of like powers. She pretty much matches Wonder Woman exactly, but she's got the gauntlets there with stars on them. She has a lasso of truth as well. And then she has red pants, again, with more of the stars, trying to go with, like, you know, America personified type form. And then she has very similar knees and legs. Obviously, she's not as thick, so she must not be truly Amazon like Wonder Woman. And then some tall black boots going on here, because obviously this is current stuff going on, so she's not going to be dressed as skimpy as people normally would, or ever back in the older comics. She's not going to stand up. Her feet are kind of bent, so I got to like fit just the joints, but of course they're stiff right now, so I got to fix them. And then for Dr. Psycho, she comes with his legs, which is kind of weird. Usually, you know, you get two separate legs, but this time they're connected together and have this weird joint that connect them to attach the body. And then we have his head here, which is kind of see. So there's his face, which we'll go ahead and put together. But that's going to be it for Wonder Girl. Okay, so here we have Dr. Psycho. Now, I could not get his arms in for anything. I don't know why, but I cannot get his arms put into the hole. So, you'll just have to bear with me that he doesn't have his arms on. But this is Dr. Psycho. So, he's a real tiny person. So, let's hold him up to Wonder Woman here. So, there you can see the ginormous size difference going on between the two figures there. So, this is Dr. Psycho. He's kind of a psychotic person, as you'd guess with the name and stuff. And so, and you can see his eyes. He's got the crazy eye going on there that kind of shows he's crazy and psychotic. But his powers kind of like deal with the supernatural, so he can like control supernatural powers and stuff. So he's in the Wonder Woman universe. He's one of her villains. And so and it said because of his like size, his stature, and he's so small, and then being psycho and stuff, he has a hatred for women. And so that's why he obviously goes after Wonder Woman and stuff and is a villain of hers. And so he's been on her storylines for quite a while. It said since like the 40s. So he's been around for quite a long time. I've never heard of him before or seen him, but he looks kind of crazy. I don't know what this is from, if it's from a newer comic or anything, because he does look obviously more modern and everything. But that's it for Dr. Psycho. Like I said, I wish I could get his arms in, but just forced everything as hard as I could, and they just would not go in, and I thought they were in, and then they'd fall out. So it's not that good to see. But that's it for Dr. Psycho. So that's going to be it for this Wonder Woman set, again, of little figures, where we had Wonder Woman and Wonder Girl. So again, it's just like a mini Wonder Woman set of figures here with just two figures doing a build-a-figure of Dr. Psycho. So I hope you enjoyed. If you did, let me know in the comments down below. And don't forget to subscribe to see more videos. And we'll see you next time.